This is a matter of deen. This ilm is a matter of deen. You be careful who you take your deen from.
So from the issues, ikhwan, of this manhaj, is that na'am, this manhaj seeks to split and separate the haq from the batil. As Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala likewise has said to his messenger, مَا كَانَ اللَّهُ لِيَذَرَ الْمُؤْمِنِينَ عَلَى مَا أَنْتُمْ عَلَيْهِ حَتَّى يَمِيزَ الْخَبِيثَ مِنَ الطَّيِّبِ. That indeed Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala was not going to leave the mu'mineen upon that which you are upon, حَتَّى يَمِيزَ الْخَبِيثَ مِنَ الطَّيِّبِ, until that which is khabith, that which is evil, that which is from khubth, is made distinguished from that which is tayyib. That which is khabith is made distinguished from that which is tayyib. And it is that which is tayyib that will receive the blessings of Jannah and will be greeted upon the doors of Jannah, as Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala has said, وَسِيقَ الَّذِينَ اتَّقَوْا رَبَّهُمْ إِلَى الْجَنَّةِ زُمَرًا حتى إذا جاءوها وفتحت أبوابها وقال لهم خزنتها سلام عليكم طبتم فادخلوها خالدين. And upon the day that the people who fear their Lord will be brought to the Jannah, Zumara, in droves and in groups, حَتَّى إِذَا جَاءُوهَا, until they reach it, وَفُتِحَتْ أَبْوَابُهَا, and its doors will be open, وَقَالَ لَهُمْ خَزَنَتُهَا, and the custodians of the Jannah will say to them, سَلَامٌ عَلَيْكُمْ, peace be upon you, طِبْتُمْ, طِبْتُمْ, indeed you were طَيِّب, indeed you were طَيِّب, فَادْخُلُوهَا خَالِدِينَ. So enter that Jannah Khalideen. So this issue of the tamyiz of the haq and the batil is something which is an asl from the usul of Salafiyyah. Likewise, from the usul of Salafiyyah is the issue of at-tasfiyah wa at-tarbiyah. From the issues which are from the usul of Salafiyyah, the issues of tasfiyah and tarbiyah. As for the issues of tasfiyah, referring to the purification of the religion from all that which has come to it by way of new affairs, innovated affairs, incorrect beliefs, false ideologies, then this is something which the Salafi is upon. That the Salafi understands that the way to the rectification of this ummah is by way of tasfiyah wa tarbiyah. Purifying the ranks, purifying the deen, purifying the sunnah, purifying the Islam, removing the false ideologies and the false ideas and the false principles, and then the tarbiyah, nurturing the Muslimun upon the pure and correct Islam. And that manhaj of tasfiyah and tarbiyah is not a new manhaj, as we find some of the people saying, that this was a manhaj that was brought about by Sheikh al-Albani. Rather, ikhwan, this manhaj is from the manhaj of the Anbiya. As Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has said concerning Ibrahim, after they had erected the Kaaba, and Ibrahim and Ismail began to make dua, he said, رَبَّنَا وَبَعَثْ فِيهِمْ رَسُولًا يَتْلُوا عَلَيْهِمْ مِنْهُمْ يَتْلُوا عَلَيْهِمْ آيَاتِكَ وَيُعَلِّمُهُمْ الْكِتَابِ وَيُزَكِّيهِمْ. O Allah, send to them a messenger from amongst themselves, yani the people of Makkah, from amongst themselves, teaching them the book and nurturing them and making tazkiyah of them and purifying them. Teaching them the tarbiyah upon the book, wa yuzakkihim, and purifying them. Ya'ani, purifying them from impurities that have come to them. This was the dua of Ibrahim, that Allah would raise an individual, a prophet, who would be upon this methodology of tasfiyah and tarbiyah. So dua, the dua of Ibrahim was that Allah would send one who would teach them the kitab and then would give them the tasfiyah wa yuzakihim. And when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala responded to that, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has said, هُوَ الَّذِي بَعَثَ فِي الْأُمِّيِّينَ رَسُولًا هُوَ الَّذِي بَعَثَ فِي الْأُمِّيِّينَ رَسُولًا مِنْهُمْ يَتْلُو عَلَيْهِمْ آيَاتِهِ وَيُزَكِّيهِمْ وَيُعَلِّمُهُمُ الْكِتَابَ وَالْحِكْمَةَ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala reversed that which had occurred in the dua of Ibrahim. Because in the dua of Ibrahim, he made dua first and foremost that he would be a messenger who would make tarbiyah, and then make the tazkiyah, then make the tasfiyah, and purify them. Allah, when He answered the dua, He responded to that dua by saying, it is He who sent a messenger, giving them tazkiyah, purifying them, and nurturing them upon the kitab and upon the hikmah. So Allah establishes for us the fact that the tasfiyah and the tarbiyah is from the deen, and that the tasfiyah precedes the tarbiyah. That the tasfiyah precedes the tarbiyah. That the purification precedes nurturing the Muslims upon that pure tawheed. Although without doubt, there are affairs which are from the get-go, the Muslims must be nurtured upon, from the issues of the wajibat and the issues of the salawat, and other than that, from those things which are wajib upon the Muslimin. So this issue of tasfiyah and tarbiyah is from the manhaj of Ahlul Sunnah wal Jama'ah, the manhaj of the Salaf al-Salihun, and from the manhaj of the Anbiya. Likewise, from the manhaj of Anbiya in tasfiyah and tarbiyah is that from the ways, ikhwan, that tasfiyah is done is by way of making rad ala al-mukhalif, by way of refuting the one who opposes the sunnah, and refuting the one who opposes this manhaj, and clarifying the batil of that which that individual is upon. And this issue of the rad ala al-mukhalif, the rad ala al-mukhalif, the rad upon the one who opposes, is likewise from the manhaj of the Anbiya. As the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam has explained to us in the hadith of Ibn Mas'ud, ما من نبي بعثه الله في أمة قبلي إلا كان له من أمته حواريون وأصحاب يأخذون بسنتي ويستنون بأمري. That there was not a messenger that was sent to a people except that he had with him followers and aiders. يأخذون بأمره, who used to hold on to his affair and who used to follow his sunnah. And then the messenger continues, then they came after them, يعني, they came after each messenger a generation or generations. يقولون ما لا يفعلون ويفعلون ما لا يؤمرون فمن جاهدهم بيده فهو مؤمن ومن جاهدهم بلسانه فهو مؤمن وَمَنْ جَاهَدَهُمْ بِقَلْبِهِ فَهُوَ مُؤْمِنٌ وَلَيْسَ وَرَاءَ ذَلِكَ مِنَ الْإِيمَانِ حَبَّةُ خَرْدَلٍ. That day, those individuals will come, they will say that which they do not do, and they will do that which they were not commanded to do, يعني from the bid'ah and the innovations. So whosoever fights against them with their hand, then he is a mu'min. And whosoever fights against them with his tongue, then he is a mu'min. And whosoever fights against them with his heart, then he is a mu'min, and there is not after that min al iman habbatu khardal. There is not after that a mustard seed of iman.